Down and now he is back from the brink for a special event in Greensboro. Now making a special appearance in the Fox 8 studios.
Whoa.
The real American himself, Hulk Hogan.
Wait a minute, it's Ric Flair.
No, it's not. Come on in. Come on in.
What's up?
Come,
how you doing?
God, it's such a pleasure to see you.
Well, thank you. It's great to be here.
Gosh, you found your way to the studios and
yeah,
all that
I
stuff,
did.
Really?
I did, yeah.
We had to get extra big size chairs for you to be able to sit down and all that stuff.
Oh, the invisible chair here. Oh, well, wait a minute.
I got to tell you, when you walked in, Cindy says, he's so big. Come on. God, you don't make a living in that
you
kind
know
of stuff.
Well, you know. It's been fun. I was bigger when I was younger, but you know how you get older and you shrink up.
You call them the Hulk for nothing. You got a big event coming up.
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me about that. Tell me why you're in town.
The Reader's Digest version is I went through a couple tough years.
Yeah.
You know, financially, on a personal level. And then all of a sudden, some people have weird situations with their bodies and carry stress in different places. Well, it all hit me at once. My back collapsed. I had all the stress in my lower back, plus everything was out of alignment from wrestling, the fake wrestling, 30 years.
Yeah.
So I had 8 back surgeries in a row, and I was pretty much bedridden. They didn't know if I'd get up and start walking. But one thing that had happened was I kind of got out of shape. I got a little bit of a tummy on me, and my niece gave me this protein powder, which basically, you know, was just some really good stuff and helped me lose some weight, and it kind of like kept the muscle on me as I was just laying there recovering. And when I ran out, there was nowhere to buy it. So I went to the website and I took a look at it and I went, oh my gosh, this is a business opportunity too.
Yeah.
So I ordered some more protein and I made a couple calls and I did the Hulk Hogan, hey brother, this is Hulk Hogan. Used the gimmick voice to get in the door. I got a 1-hour meeting.
You even Hulk on the phone?
Yeah, I did. Oh, well, I did it just to get in.
There's the card he played there.
Thank you. Yeah. And it was supposed to be a 1-hour business meeting with this company, Visalus.
Yeah.
And at the end of the meeting, I said, well, why are you guys really doing this? And they said, we want to help and we want to serve people. I went, okay, well, that 1-hour meeting turned into an 11-hour meeting. And what I realized was this is a huge business opportunity. Not only is it a chance to get healthy and lose some weight, you know, with the economy and with everything going on with the houses and the foreclosure and the job market.
Yeah.
You know, I had a tough time, and I'm moving forward and getting back on my feet even financially. And when I saw what was happening with this company, I went, you know what? All the fans that have supported me and been loyal through good and bad times, I said, I want to let them know about this. And you don't get anything for nothing. There's a lot of hard work involved. But if you're not afraid of hard work, there's a huge opportunity here. And I just want to let people know that.
And that's what you're going to be talking about.
Yes,
you talk about tough times and things like that. You go through a lot. But I was reading an interview that you did with Forbes, and it talks about positive attitude. You said you look for positive things in your life.
Yes,
sir. There's so much negative out there.
Yes, sir.
You just stay positive.
Well, you know, I had to make a choice.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't want to browbeat people to death with religion, but... You know, intelligent people usually make the higher choice, and it was being negative or God. He said, she said, or God. Getting even or God. Being mad about life or God. And all of a sudden, I went, man, I'm going to make the higher choice. And when you start making the higher choice, things happen. You know, everything gets positive. You start moving in the right direction. Doors open. You get back on your feet. You surround yourself with good people, good situations. And that's what happened with my life. I got so far down with my personal situation and what was going on business-wise that I had no choice but to either lay there in the gutter or get up and make a choice and stand back up. And I chose to make the higher choice.
I got to ask you, you're such a nice guy. When you're sizing somebody up in the ring, what's the look you give them across the ring? What do you do? Show me the look that you would give. Is that good? Look right in here.
Yeah, I'm a great bluffer.
I want to see. Okay, no, but show me.
Okay,
because I got to size up Farmer over here every morning.
Okay, I'm a great bluffer.
Okay, give me the face.
Give him the Sylvester Stallone snarl. And then you go, yikes! Whoa!
Do you think it'll work?
I don't
have the whole everything else.
You know, you've got way too much hair on your head.
Okay.
We should probably shave a big bald spot so you'll have
a
Hulk Hogan haircut.
We're going to work on that.
Grow the stash in.
We're
going to
work
set,
on that.
Brother.
Thank you so much, man.
Thank you
what
for
a pleasure meeting this
Thank
guy.
You,
Tell
sir.
You what. Back from the break. It is set for Friday. War Memorial Auditorium in Greensboro. Fun starts at 7:30. Need more information or tickets or things like that, myfox8.com. Click on the morning news page. Roy's Real Deal winners are coming up next. I can't do that.
You're there. You're there.
I'm gonna do it.
This portion of the Fox 8 News is sponsored by H.H. Gregg.